Hey y'all. Hey you. Good morning. I know I'm looking particularly rough. I just woke up. My eyes all puffy. This was a long, long night. I didn't get a chance to vlog yesterday to end my day to tell you about the fabulous time we had out and about here in Los Angeles, California. I'm outside drinking coffee. It's so nice here. I cannot even believe it. And we actually, I think I mentioned this yesterday, but we actually sleep with the windows open. The weirdest feeling ever. I haven't done that since I was a kid, staying at my grandmother's house. Oh my gosh. Oh, y'all gotta excuse this situation here. It's looking rough in these streets. Anyway, so I'm sitting outside, and so if you hear the traffic, I just wanted to be in the natural habitat of it all. I mean, clubs, dope, everybody's still sleeping now. Just want to be out here and just, it's the ambiance. It's just, it's wonderful. I think when I buy my next house, I'm going to buy a house with a porch that I can actually sit on and drink coffee. You know, surprisingly enough, I haven't even gone to Starbucks, and they have this other coffee place that I see here called Coffee Bean, I think it is. I may check that out tomorrow when I take mom to the airport. Yeah, she's leaving us tomorrow. She had to cut hers a little short, day short, because my niece is with her and she has to go to school. So this is officially day 3. But I'm gonna recap day 2 because I just have to. So I was able to get my podcast in with Jordan Murillo, who was absolutely a pleasure to talk to. He was so much fun. He had a lot of energy. He was just, his aura was just beautiful. I mean, you know, you don't come across many people who are genuinely nice, who wants to engage with you. Don't even know you from a can of paint, but chooses to engage with you. And I thought that was a lot of fun. I definitely appreciated him. I appreciate all his good information. He is a personal trainer. So definitely check him out, Jordan Moreno, on Instagram and YouTube. It's hot too, ladies. So after that, we all got ourselves together, paid for a tour, and we went to on a Hollywood tour. We got to see the sights. Now, I could have sworn that they told us that we were going to go to the Hollywood sign and actually get out and be able to take a picture, but that wasn't the case. I was really disappointed because we were like on a mountain far, far away. And okay, so we weren't nowhere near the sign, so we had to climb up some stairs and was able to take pictures from another mountain. And the Hollywood sign was way over yonder. I was like, okay, I thought we were gonna get out, be able to climb, be able to take a picture. So maybe we could squeeze that in today. I don't know, but it was really, really beautiful. And oh my gosh, these homes now. I ain't gonna try to expand my vocabulary here. Probably it's not gonna happen because I can't think beyond amazing, fabulous, scary. Because those are my go-to verbs. Not those verbs. Don't judge me. Anyway, I just, the houses were, oh my gosh, we saw Tyler Perry's home. We saw Denzel Washington. We actually went by the house that Justin Bieber is renting. $65,000 a month. Excuse me. Sorry. I was getting the attitude for no reason there, but I still have an attitude. $65,000 a month he's renting for this home, which is absolutely fabulous. It looks like a spinning salad bowl. Has these blue windows. So if you ever see him out and about, not out and about, but paparazzi pictures of him with in the, and it has a blue tint to it. That's where he lives. We was all up in that space. We saw his, I think it was a Maserati. It's another fancy car, and it had cleaning people in there, because I was told by the tour guide that he was having a party that night. Of course, I didn't go. I didn't have time. I had other things to do. But had I not had prior plans, I definitely would have rolled on through there. Okay. You hear that California traffic? It is so soothing. There's a lot of trucks on this road. This road here kind of reminds me of 1960, which 1960 is a major, not freeway, highway, a major road in Houston that we travel a lot. It's always a lot of traffic, a lot of accidents. It's very busy. You don't want to cross it because it will get you killed. Anyway, so yeah, but it was just odd just seeing all these homes. Okay, that's a truck, huge truck. It was just odd just seeing these homes. It was like the mountains are what they are, and it looks like they just carved out a section. Like if you have a picture mountain, and you just get your shovel or your pitchfork or whatever, and just carve out a space. And just stick a rock in there. That's what it looks like. Matter of fact, get some Play-Doh. Sculpt it like a mountain. Get, just dig in it and just pull a chunk out the side of it and then mold it really nicely. And then get your kids' Lego and just stick it inside. And do that in several places randomly along the mountain of Play-Doh. Then you have some California homes. As much as I admire these homes and much as I am in awe, even if I had that type of money, I just don't think I could do it. Now, Denzel Washington house looks like it was at the bottom of the mountain because it was this little area. It was like Denzel Washington, Tyler Perry, and of course, he had to show us where the sharp shooters are strategically placed when Barack Obama spends the night at Tyler Perry's house. I'm just like, okay, Tyler. Anyway, they were beautiful. And just, okay, this tour guide, they drive like maniacs out here. I feel like I'm in New York. I've only been to New York a couple of times, but the driving is insane. Insane. So I actually thought that it gives me that feeling of that New York driving where people just cutting you off, hitting those corners on two tires. That's how I felt in that tour guide bus. And we were on a mountain, so of course we were spiraling up and spiraling down this mountain and looking over the abyss. I don't even know if that's correct, but we were just looking over yonder. And it was so beautiful. Oh my gosh. I saw Katy Perry's home, and we went up all in her space also. Justin Timberlake. I hope you saw me on camera. And who else stood out for me? Oh my gosh. I can't think of her name. God bless the day. The young lady who played in Star Wars, Princess Leia. I cannot think of her real name. We went to her home, and it's still the same as it was before she passed. And it showed where her mother lived also. I'm so bad with names, y'all forgive me, but I am a fan, but I just can't remember her name right now. And who else? Oh my, there were just so many, too many to count. It's like they all are neighbors. I guess you just, and we went to the, we saw the walking trails where the actors go in between movies and where they walk their dogs and do hiking and things like that. Yeah. I was hoping to see Zac Efron because the guy said he does hike there, this little hiking spot. He hikes there a lot, and he was there a lot during Baywatch. Oh, I saw Gwen Stefani's and, oh my God, what is his fine self? His 6'5 fine self that she's dating. Can't remember his name either, which I know who I'm talking about. He plays on the Voice. He's on the Voice. He's a country singer. It's right there. I can't think of it. I brushed my teeth. I did brush my teeth. I managed to do that. I can't do anything without brushing my teeth in the morning before I drink coffee. I know it changes the flavor and probably the texture of the coffee. I don't know, but I just can't see myself drinking coffee or eating. My daughter says, I don't do my food a favor when I brush my teeth before I eat. She said, you need to be able to, those juices that have marinated in your mouth overnight, it's just like you just marinate the food, gives it a whole different, just like that's some nasty shit. Ugh, I would never. I don't think I've ever eaten anything without brushing my teeth. I don't think even as a kid, it's just something about, ugh, I don't even want to talk about it. I don't even know how I brought that up. I think because it's so early, I feel like y'all can smell my breath. But it's pumpkin spice. Shit. I'm so embarrassed. Yeah. So I didn't use my camera all that much yesterday. I had a lot of stuff in my book bag. I normally carry a purse, but I felt like I wanted a book bag because I wanted to be hands-free. But going between my iPhone 7 Plus and my Sony and these, what's these things called? Selfie sticks. Yeah, it was a lot. And nobody's helping me. Nobody is entertaining my vlog. They're so busy doing their own thing. I see smoke. Is somebody smoking down there? I didn't even know people smoke in California. I thought this was this vegan, smoke-free, hippie type place. We saw the studios where they record a lot of shows, and they actually told us we could take a tour and see Ellen and all that, but it's probably too late now. It's Saturday now, so we missed that opportunity because we ended up getting dropped off on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. You know, I don't know what I thought, but I can tell you what I thought. I thought those stars were, I thought those stars were protected. I thought they were cherished. I thought they were held in the highest esteem ever. And I guess it is at the time. And then very well maybe now, I don't know. But I just kind of felt like, I don't know. I kind of felt like I was walking on people's stars. You know how graveyards are designed now where they're not the same like with the, some of them are. But the one lately that I've been to, God bless it in, the headstones are flat in the ground. And I guess because of space, the higher rate of death, that they kind of like place the bodies all right beside each other. It's like you're walking over a grave to get to the grave that you're trying to get to visit, or even to go to the grave site to go bury somebody. It's like you're walking on people's graves. And I personally don't like doing that. I still believe that you don't point at graveyards, you don't walk on people's graves. It's like, I know they're no longer there, whole nother topic, but I think it's just so disrespectful. So I kind of felt like that when I was walking down the Hollywood Walk of Fame, that I'm just stepping on people's accomplishments, achievements, their moments, because when they put those stars down there, they take these pictures, they make it so grand, and it's like cutting the ribbon, and I don't know, it just felt weird. But I did step on them though. I mean, there's no other way. I mean, that whole strip was packed too, and I was so, oh my gosh, I had so much anxiety because it was so many people. Then you had all these people on the streets who, I guess they work for money, not prostitutes, but just people on the streets, like a whole cast of people were dressed up like the Justice League and Thor and, you know, Batman and all of them. They were sexy, even though they was wearing bodysuits. I say, if Michael Jackson come across here one more time, called my mama Janet, that was funny. They want you to take pictures with them, I guess. We walk all up and down there, peeked in shops, basking in the ambiance of it all. It was very, for me, it was frightening. I'm just like, you don't know who to trust, you don't know who's pickpocketing, you don't know what the hell's going on. Oh my gosh, I look a hot mess. You just don't know. Yeah. It was interesting. And we went to Madame Tussauds Wax Museum. After we ate, of course, we went there. It was fun. I don't even know if it's what I expected. These narrow alleys in these apartments are so weird to me. I wonder how much they pay rent here. I think I slowed down talking because people are out here. You know, I had this fear. I have nothing yesterday. I really couldn't vlog during the tour for Hollywood because of the wind, the speed. I was scared my phone or my camera would fly off. These selfies did. So much noise. And the guy was talking, so I couldn't talk. And I know you didn't want to hear a muffled tour guide. So I didn't share that. But even when I was walking around, when we did stop, it's like people staring at you when you're vlogging. And it's a weird feeling. I have to, if I'm gonna do this, I need to be like, fudge it, and just record and talk and let that be it. I don't know, from a can of paint. Seriously. I don't know where they're going. So we went to Madame Tussauds. Oh, I got a chance to see Rihanna with her sexy self. I took a picture with her. It was weird though. It was weird. They were just, oh. It was weird. I took a lot of pictures though, even though those wax clones of the celebrities. Oh my God. Okay, now a lot of them, even though they were who they were, I guess they must have been taken, sculpted a long time ago, because I didn't recognize Halle Berry. I didn't recognize Jennifer Lopez. I definitely didn't recognize Lady Gaga. I took a picture with her, but that did not do her any justice. She looked like a pasted mummy. I don't know why they did Gaga like that. She should have never approved that outfit. Beyonce looked good. They even had the actual muscle tone in her legs. Who else did I see? Will Smith, his forehead was shiny. I don't know how I felt about that. John Travolta was extra slim. I think he was even slimmer in that wax figure than he was in actual grease. I took a picture with Thor. Iron Man held my hand. Wolverine. You know, I'm kind of disappointed in him that he's not doing Wolverine character anymore. I just always thought he couldn't die. I mean, I was running through there like a kid in a candy store. I sat by Simon, but he didn't pay me any attention. I kind of feel like that's his personality with everybody anyway. Who else? Oh, the single ladies. Yeah, I had fun in there. It was Forrest Gump character, Tom Hanks. Yeah, I sat with him. He wouldn't share his chocolates. Who else? I should have wrote this down because I met so many wax figures. Those things, like I said, they are so lifelike. We was told not to touch the face, don't touch the hair. But oh my gosh. Edward Scissorhands, who was that? Johnny Depp? I crouched down with Spider-Man. I couldn't get the exact pose, but I was close. There were so many of them. They are so lifelike. Where do these people get this talent from? I just feel like I missed my calling. How can I miss a calling on something I never had, a talent I never had? I don't know. We all been here to be who we are and capitalize on what we're born with, I guess. But I'm just like, when God was passing out the talent, he just totally just, this person that just skipped me out. You just get me. I'm grateful though for what I can do. I'm an analyst. I guess it was up to me to take my analytical skills to a different level. That's my responsibility, I guess. He gave me the ability to be analytic, which I can't really say I 100% am, you know? I do have a creative mind, but I limit myself. Anyway, I'm on a tangent. So we went to Madame Cusso's, and then we had to take the dreadful walk back to the car. Can you say scary moments? We was all in a bunch walking like Oompa Loompas, the trolls, or whatever. They are, them people that walk in a bunch at the same time. We're walking fast to the car. It was scary. Anyway, so we managed to get back to the car. It was a fun day, though. We had a lot of fun. It was really, really fun. I enjoyed spending time with my family. We took a lot of great pictures. We took this picture, this mugshot picture also. All of us held up these mugshot signs. I'm going to post that in this vlog. Very cute pictures. And then we lost my train of thought. We went to Ralph's, which I've never heard of Ralph's, but it's their local grocery store here. We went to Ralph's. Even got us a discount Ralph card, even though we'll never use it again. Here we go with all these damn groceries and no bags. 10 cents a freaking bag. Now, granted, I was fussing about this when I went to Target. Well, not fussing, but, you know, acknowledging the fact that we had to pay for bags. But the bags were cute in Target form, all dressed with stripes and red, colorful, had a little handle. Ralph's bag had handles also, but it was like a regular, I mean, when I say handle, I mean not the kind of handles, you know, the little hole you stick your hand through, they don't bust the hole in some plastic. No, I mean some real handles. But the Ralph bags, they weren't worth 10 cents a bag. Okay, if you're going to charge me maybe 5 cents, they were smaller. Couldn't get a lot in them. I'm just like, I didn't get it. I didn't get it. I just don't get it. I don't understand. Maybe I need to do my little research here and find out why they're charging for bags here in California. And they look at us like we're crazy. Stop complaining, people. If you're going to get a bag, get a bag. If not, throw your shit in your grocery basket and get paid and get out. That's how I felt. I need to play lottery too. It's just my to-do. Anyway, my coffee's getting kind of cold. So we came back here last night, made some nachos, fried up some shrimp. I know that doesn't go together, but everybody has different taste buds. And we played Uno. We reacted to some videos. We danced to some videos. We had fun. I drank a little bit, well, a lot of too. I drank too much wine. Got a little headache now. That's why I'm trying to get this coffee in my system. I done took 2 Tylenols and yeah, I guess I'm gonna wash clothes today. But today is day 3 and I got 2 podcast conversations. I hate to say interviews. It's so informal, you know, because I like to think when I do my podcast, Tea with Monroe, that I'm having conversations with people, you know, not necessarily interviewing, even though I'm asking questions, getting to know them, trying to figure out where they are in life, you know, how my platform can help them and how their platform can help me, what they are, you know, whatever. It is kind of questiony and it does turn into conversationally. But I like to say conversations because it seems more intimate. I have conversations with people. And so I have 2 conversations scheduled today. And then I think we're going to head over to Venice Beach. I don't know what to wear, though. I'm torn. I think I may go buy me some leggings. Because the weather here, it's nice out. It's not as out here as I thought it was. I don't even know what the temperature is. But yesterday was like, I woke up to 66 degrees. All right. Okay, everybody. So I'm going to go beat this face, which my definition of beat is brush my eyebrows, put on some moisturizer, and some lipstick. it for me. I don't even refresh my lipstick during the day. I be looking a hot mess. By the end of the day, my lipstick is now eyeliner. I mean lip liner with gel bars, because you know the cracks in your lips. I don't know. I'm just never been that type to be all in the mirror refreshing lipstick or anything for that matter. Anyway, let me go get my life right now and get ready for my conversations and plan this out. And cook some breakfast. And then, I know I keep looking away because it's just, I love it. A lot of graffiti here. Maybe we'll venture out today and do, we're going to Venice Beach. Another pier, I can't think of. I kind of want to go to that Hollywood sign though. But anyway, that's neither here nor there. All right, y'all.